pag niligtas ba tayo ng Panginoon? O tayo niligtas na ng Panginoon? Ano bang niligtas sa atin ng Panginoon? Ano bang niligtas sa atin ng Panginoon? Spirit? Soul? O body? Ano ba niligtas sa atin?
Soul.
Na, iba-iba. Understanding. Sino nagsasabing spirit? Sino nagsasabing soul? Sino nagsasabing body? Sino walang pakialam? Tasa ka may. Bahala ka dyan. Bahala kayo dyan. Pakialam din niyo. Sino nagsasabing lahat niligtas? Yeah. Magiging malinaw ngayon sa inyo pagkatapos natin. Right? So that's why it's very important really to attend this Bible schooling, no? this leadership enhancement training. Benepisyo ng kaligtasan sa atin. Ano ba yung nakinabang sa atin? Ano ba yung niligtas, nililim ng Panginoon sa atin? Okay? Genesis 1:26-27. Sabi rito, let us make man in our image. So sabi dito, and God said, let us make man in our image, according to our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, over the earth, all over the earth, and over everything that creeps on the earth. So God created man in His own image, in the image of God. He created him, male and female. He created them. So, malinaw na ang tao'y nilikha ng Diyos. Amen? Hindi tayo gamit sa tungkoy. May evolution. Kasi may nagtuturo. No, yung mga hindi naniniwala sa Diyos, yung Darwin theory of evolution coming from the teaching of Big Bang theory, that everything started from the singular explosion, singularity they call it, no? That's the belief of the atheistic scientist, no? Mga atheist, hindi naniniwala sa Diyos. Now, papayag pa kayo, lagi ninyo ang Diyos. Ay, di ba, lahat yung pinag-ibig. Wala ka sa pinag-ibig. Basta ka. And don't think so. It's very clear in the creation, God created, no? Animals, and then finally, He created this special creature. Look at the person beside you. You are created special. And He was talking about special God.
Special
child. Iba na yun. Okay, so yun, clean and special, diba? So hindi tayo galing sa mula sa evolution at galing sa God. Now, basic definition. Spirit, the dimension of man that deals with the spiritual realm. The part of man that knows God. That knows God. The part of man that knows God is spirit. Okay? I will explain it in a simplistic form para mas lalo yung maintindihan. Para alam nyo paano ipaliwanag in a simplistic form. Okay, later ba? May kurumot ako ba sa rin? Susimplify ko sa rin. Sabi rito, 1 Corinthians 2:14, communication between God and man is spirit to spirit. Amen. 1 Corinthians 2:14, it says, but the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God. Look at this. If you are a natural man, you don't have the Spirit of God, therefore you cannot receive the things that are spiritual. Amen. For they are foolishness to him, nor can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. The things that are spiritual can be discerned spiritually. So how can a natural man be able to discern the things that are spiritual unless he is born again? Because only a person who is born again shall have the Spirit of God. That's why we are preaching the gospel, so that the people may be born again and may receive the Spirit of God. The moment they receive the Spirit of God, then it is the Spirit of God that will teach us into all truth. All although God is using ministers of the gospel, like apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers, to equip the saints. Okay? Just like me, no, I'm here as one of the fivefold ministers to equip you with the things that are spiritual. But since you have the Spirit of God, it will help you understand what we are talking about. Amen. So that's why it's important that you have, that your spirit is alive. The only way that your spirit is alive when you are born again. Kaya tawag sa akin mga alay-alay yan. Diba? Masira ulo, alay-alay yan. Pinatigin nila, hindi nila alam kung tayo ang buhay. Sapagkat ang espiritu meron sa atin ay espiritu ng Diyos. Sila mga patay. Amen. At wala silang pagkakunawa sa mga bagay na sa atin. Yung mga buhay na lang sa espiritu ng Diyos. Amen. Praise God. And then so, the dimension of man which deals with the mental realm, the sensibilities and the will. The part that reasons and thinks, the soul is made up of three parts. Remember this, mind, emotions, and will, or will and emotion. Mind, kasi sinisimula ko, mind, emotion, and will, power. Will, mga disposition sa buhay. So kapag tama ang isip, tama ang puso, tama ang mga disposition sa buhay. Amen! Amen. Eh, sabi sa pag may tama ka ba? Ibang tama kasi yung dating ito. Tama ng katotohanan. Praise God. Sinano ka lang para medyo laging sigur-sigur-iwa natin. Ha? Alright, so this is what refer to awa, to as awa, personality. Now, is it becoming clear now? It is the soul that where we can find our personality. Yung pagiging tayo. Yung pagiging kung ano. That's where we can find the mind, the emotion, right? And then, the body. The dimension of man which deals with the physical realm. The house in which you live. Think of yourself as a spiritual being who possesses a soul and lives in a physical body. Amen. So, yan yung katawan natin. Our body is our covering. Okay? It covers our spirit and our soul. Amen. Now, sabi rito, 2 Corinthians 4:16, therefore we do not lose heart. Even though our outward man is perishing, yet the inward man is being renewed day by day. Amen. So it is the inward man that is being renewed day by day. The spirit of man and the soul of man. Amen. Paul delighted in God's law, in his inner being. He refers to the outward man and the inward man. Our outward man is our physical body. Our inward man is our spirit and soul. Now, is it becoming clear now? Managing malinaw na, no? Okay, let's continue. Now, the spirit, no, has something to do with the, has something to do with the connection with God, no? O kaya God's consciousness. It is the spirit of man that connects with God, who is spirit. Amen? So, the spirit of man has something to do with God consciousness. Okay? It's the spirit of man that becomes conscious about God. It is the spirit of man that connects with God. Amen? That's why a man who is dead spiritually has no connection with God. That is what the Bible teaches in Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1. You are dead in your trespasses and sins. The word death refers to spiritual death. A person who walks in sinfulness anybody dead person. That's why no way for that person to be able to connect with that with God who is spirit. That's why a person needs to be born again. You see? You see why we are sharing the gospel? Why a person needs to be born again so that the Spirit of God, okay, may come into his life and dwell into his life. And when the Spirit of God dwells in the life of a born-again person, that's where the Spirit of man can connect with the Spirit of man. So remember that the Spirit of man has something to do with God consciousness. If you see, simplify ko na. And then the soul of man has something to do with man's consciousness. So you become conscious of about you yourself being a person. Okay? Amen? So, kaya nagiging aware ka na ngayon. Ano ba dapat ang maging personality mo? Yung pagkamang dating ano, palakaway, dating nagkaroon, dating manginino, at kung ano pa. Matundang ka nilang consciousness sa personality, hindi pala tama ito. Diba? See? So, nagkakaroon na ng man's consciousness. So, kaya nagiging maingat ka na sa isip mo, sa iyong damdamin, at sa iyong mga pagdesisyon sa buhay. Kasi, nababago na ang iyong personality. Ang isip, ang puso, at ang iyong mga disposisyon sa buhay, nababago na. Amen! Kasi yung Espiritu ng Diyos, yung Espiritu ng tao na born again, nakakakonect ka na sa Espiritu ng Diyos. Kaya when he studies the Word of God, this is spiritual. By the way, no? This is spiritual. The Word of God is spiritual in nature. And that's when he begins to understand the things that are spiritual in the Word of God. Amen. Why? Because the Spirit of God that is in a born-again person is the one illuminating. Illuminating, meaning to say, is the one enlightening, no? That person to understand the things that are spiritual, which are written in the very words. You see the beauty of understanding your being, a person, being a man? See? That's why it's very important for us to understand the spirit, the body, and the soul, which are the three components of man. Alright, so now the body has something to do with world consciousness. World, mundo, world consciousness. What is going on around us? Okay? We become conscious of what's going on around us, around in this world. Nagiging conscious ka tayo. Nagiging maingat ka tayo, right? Because the spirit of man is now alive, connecting to the Spirit of God, and then giving us the understanding of the spiritual things in the Word of God. So therefore, the Spirit of God brings this understanding to your mind, to your soul. Your soul is composed of your mind, composed of will. And that changes, therefore, your personality as a man. You become godly. Unlike before, you are ungodly. Unlike before, you are worldly. Now, you become worldly, not worldly, worldly. Meaning to say, you are now being grounded with the Word of God. And now, it changes your mind. It transforms your mind, your emotion, and your willpower. And so therefore, you become conscious of the things that is going on around you in this world. Right? And so therefore, your body who is connected with this world, it is connected in this world, no? Through the five senses. Through the five senses, your body using the five senses connects to the world. The sense of sight, sense of smell, sense of taste, sense of touch, and sense sense of hearing, right? So these are the five senses, no? That is in your body that connects to the world. That's why you receive what's going on in the world. Now, since you are now spiritually alive, and your spirit connects to the Spirit of God, and it gives you an understanding of the things that are spiritual in the Word of God, and that makes your soul becomes transformed, and so therefore your soul will now control your body. You begin to hate the things that are worldly. You begin to hate the things that are ungodly. You begin to hate the things that are wicked, that are evil. Amen? So this is the connection of the spirit, soul, and heart. Amen? So, di ba palakpakan muna natin ang Panginoon? Come on, can you get it? Okay, now, how man was made? Genesis 2:7, living being. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living being. No? So, look at this. Here you can see the three components of man. First, God formed man out of the dust of the ground. That's the body, physical. And breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, that is spirit. And man became a living being. In other translation, living soul. That is the soul. See? The three components of man are found here. No? See? God formed Adam's physical body. Then he breathed his spirit, no? His life source into that physical body. Man came out of the inside of God. We are much closer to the image of the divine than we realize. God does not speak to man nor reveal things to man through his physical being. Our spirit knows what is in our heart. Remember, God is not physical in nature. He is divine and he is spirit in nature. Amen. The only way for God to understand God's spirit is for our spirit to be made alive again by the Spirit of God, so that we can be able to connect with God. Our spirit knows what is in our heart. God communicates with man through his spirit. Through the spirit of man, God communicates. Amen? The Holy Spirit takes the thoughts of God and reveals them to us through our spirit into our heart. Amen. That's why it's very important for you to understand that a man who is not worthy, no way for that person to communicate with God. Naman, Satan, man, and God. Kailangan yun yung state. Buti na yun. Alright, so spirit, soul, and body.
Kapala yung bottom.
Look at this description. This is the spirit
of man,
the soul of man, and the body of man. Okay, now, when a man is not God, therefore, he does not know the things that are spiritual. Are you following?
Amen.
So, if the spirit is dead spiritually, there's no way that the spirit, no, can communicate to the soul or can feed the soul. He cannot feed the soul that is the spiritual. Are you following? Since there's no feeding from the spirit, the soul, no, will look for feeding. It needs to be nourished. So the body has connection with the world. Okay? The body with the five senses. No, I already gave you the five senses, no? Sense of sight, smell, taste, no, hearing, and touch, no, touching. Now, since the spirit of man God is dead. Now, the soul has no feeling from the spirit of man. So the soul did not receive feeling from the body, from the flesh. The flesh connects to the world. Okay? So whatever the flesh, no, receives from the world, then defeats the soul. Alright? So whatever the body receives from the world, defeats the soul. So the body, the flesh, see, the body is the flesh. The flesh is worldly. Okay, so everything we receive from the world, okay, that is worldly, that is ungodly, everything, it fits to the soul. Okay, look at this. So, you follow, no? Ito ka, susunod ka lang, susunod ka lang. Wala kayong magagawa ka kayo. Ito nagpapakain sa'yo. See, that's how man is being manipulated by the body. Yeah, that's the problem with the person who is not yet born again. He is manipulated by the flesh. The body is the flesh, and the flesh is worldly. Are you following? That's the problem with man. That's why the Bible says the flesh is sinful. Amen? Amen. And that's what's happening to all the people who are sinners, who are not yet born again. They are being manipulated by the flesh. That's why they keep on sinning. Amen? Because what they are receiving, things that are worldly, these are the things that they are doing. The things that are not. Okay? Now, once a person is born again, person is now born again, the spirit becomes alive. Amen. The spirit of God, no, will now come into the person. Okay. And once the spirit of God dwells in the person, remember, every born again Christian has the spirit of God inside of us. Amen.
Amen.
We are now the temple of the Holy Spirit. Are you happy for that? Amen. Can you give a clap of thanks to the Lord? So, we are now the temple of the Holy Spirit, and since the spirit of man is now the temple of the Holy Spirit, we have now the spirit of God. Now, the spirit of God can now communicate directly with God. And then God, through the Holy Spirit, will now help you illumine this understanding, the things that are spiritual in the Word of God. And so therefore, the moment you understand the things that are spiritual, then you will now feel the soul of the things that are spiritual. And then that's when transformation takes place. Faith coming by hearing and hearing and hearing the word. So as you continue receiving from the word of God, through the spirit of God, you will continue feeling the soul. Then the soul becomes transformed from glory to glory. Every time you hear and hear and hear the word of God, the soul becomes transformed from glory to glory. So the mind becomes renewed, the emotion becomes renewed, and the willpower becomes renewed, becomes transformed. Amen. So what happens now, since the soul now is now receiving the things that are spiritual from the spirit of man, is now alive because he's now born again. Having that spiritual things that you receive from the spirit of man, then your mind, emotion, and willpower have been renewed. Then it's now time for you to control the body. Amen. Unlike before, you are being controlled by the body. The spirit can do nothing because the spirit was dead. But now, no, the spirit is alive, feeding you with the things that spiritual. You take them now. Renew your mind, emotion, and your willpower. Then it's now time for you to control body dissolve. Body will be controlled by the soul, and the soul is receiving feeding from. So it's the spirit of God through the spirit of man that is born again, that is now directing the life of a person. Okay? So go, you go around. Let you follow. See, that is what's going, that is now what's happening to a person that is being born again. You see, the moment a person is born again and he's receiving feeding continually from the Spirit of God, by continually meditating upon the Word of God, continually studying the Word of God, the Spirit of God will continue receiving that spiritual feeding through the Spirit of God, and the Spirit of man will continue feeding, and the soul will continue receiving feeding from the Spirit of man, from the Spirit of God, by the spiritual things from the Word of God. Then his mind, emotion, and will be renewed, and then he will now be able to control the flesh, the body. And then the body is the flesh, composed of the five senses. You begin to hate, through your sense of eyes, outside, your eyes will begin to hate those things that are ungodly in your sight. The smell of the alcohol will become a bad smell for your nose, and then. Whenever you are the cigarette that you are smoking, it become bad taste to your mouth. And then the test. And the things that you are hearing that are ungodly, like speaking bad words, it becomes bad to your hearing. And everything that you see that is, let's say, pornography and other things, it becomes bad to your eyes. And what else? So everything, and then you hate to touch anymore the things that are ungodly. Amen? You will not go anymore to a place wherein there is what we call the lifeboat. You know what I mean? You will not hate going to the bar, right? Right? Because your being a person is now renewed. Being born again, you experience the presence of God, you experience the things that are spiritual. And day by day, through receiving the things that are spiritual from the Word of God, it changes you from glory to glory until the change, the likeness of our Lord. And through the second Adam, and Jesus Christ is the second Adam. Amen. Who is the second Adam? Jesus Christ. So being the second Adam, Jesus Christ gives us again the opportunity to recall that position. Amen? To restore back to that position of being beautiful in the eyes of God. When I say beautiful, you will look beautiful in the eyes of God when you are born again in the Spirit of God by faith in the Lord Jesus. You will receive the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. And when you have the righteousness of God, you become beautiful in life. Amen. God does not look at the outward appearance. God looks at the heart. 1 Samuel chapter 16, they preach it. Amen. Praise God. Okay, so 1 Corinthians 2:10, but God has revealed them to us through His Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yet that we do things of God. So again, revelation knowledge comes from God through your spirit. Sense knowledge comes through your five physical senses. Okay, so malinaw na, no? Malinaw na ba? Is it now clear to everyone? Now, spiritual death, this is the problem now. Here comes the problem. Genesis 2, 16, verse 17. Genesis 2, chapter 2, verses 16 to 17. And the Lord God commanded man, saying, saying of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat. For in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely night. You see, everything in the Garden of Eden, it was given by God. You can eat any fruit from the tree except from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. But eventually, Adam disobeyed God. Amen. Hebrew, in dying, thou shalt die. Spiritual death eventually brought physical death. So, started with the spiritual death, and then eventually you will experience a man, will experience, a person will experience physical death. And then eventually, eternal death. So, there are three kinds of death. The spiritual death, God said Adam would die that day, yet he lived physically for another 9 days, so this is not referring to physical death. This was spiritual death. Spiritual death is a main truth, by the term spiritual death, it does not mean that man ceases to be a spirit being. Spiritual death is not a state of non-existence, it is a condition of being separated and alienated from God. So now is it now clear to everyone, when we talk about spiritual death, it does not mean physically you are separated from God, no. Spiritually, you are separated, amen? Because of your sin, and because God is holy, you are now sinful, you are a sinner, the light and the darkness cannot go together. That's why you become alienated from God. Because of that sin, you are sinful. Amen? That's why a person becomes spiritually dead. Spiritually dead. Luke 15, 31, 32. He was not physically dead, he was separated from his father. And he said to him, Son, you are always with me, and all that I have is yours. It was right that you should make Mary and your brother. Your brother was dead and is alive again. And was lost and is found. No? So, that's why we need to reach out to the people. Amen. Because of this sin, because we inherited that sin from our forefather Adam, according to Romans chapter 5 verse 12. I want you to open your Bible.
Ayan na pala ba? Amay, ilagay. Pangapal, andun niya pala. Amay, i-YouTube dito. Ayan na pala rin pala.
During creation, when he was created by God, he has a by God, it was twisted by Satan. Right? When Adam saw the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, the fruit was very beautiful. It was pleasing in the eyes. No? It was pleasing in the belly. You see? Right? And then what Satan said? Do you know that if you eat the fruit of the tree, you will become like God? You will know good and evil. Right? Diba yung sabi niya na? And then, here comes the pride of Adam. So that's why the sin of Adam is threefold. Lust of the eyes, lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, wishing to the eyes, lust of the eyes. He had just this desire to, lust of the eyes, then lust of the flesh. No? He wants to fill in his belly. And then, pride of life, he wants to become like God. It's good to become like God, knowing good. And so, he allowed himself to eat the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good. Through his wife, So, what happens now? So, man has free will. God's will, do not need. Are you getting everything except that we are not able to live here? And the Satan's will, do you know that if you eat that, you will become like that? Right? So, he has a free will, he has the choice, which he will follow. Will he submit to the will of God, or will he submit his free will to the will? To the will of God. Man's will submitted his will to the will of God. So what happened to man now? Why man becomes sinner or sinful? Simply because his will has now captivated by the will of the evil. Amen. Now question, does man still have a free will after the fall? Does man still has a free will after the fall? Therefore, before the fall, man has the free will. After the fall, his will becomes submitted to the will of the evil one. That's why his inclination is evil in his life. That's why the tendency of man is to do evil. That's why man becomes sinner. Because his will is now captivated by the will of the devil. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 26. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 26. Ano mo na dyan, ha? The devil, at least, having been taken captive by him to do his will. So the people were taken captive by the evil one to do his will. You see? So that's why everyone becomes sinner. Because the inclination of the person, of the man, after the fall, is evil in his mind and his heart. That's why a man needs to be born again so that his will will become free again. Now question, does the man still has the will? Yes, he still has the will, but his will is no longer free, but his will is submitted to the will of the evil one. Are you following? But the moment a man is born again, his free will is restored. Amen.
Amen.
That's how he can now choose. Whether he will continue with the Lord I will continue with the evil things that he used to do before. Amen? But before, yes. Prior to the fall, he has the figure, he has the features. Prior to the fall. After the fall, his inclination becomes evil. Because his spirit is captivated by the evil one. But after being born again, his will is becomes free again. That's why the will, the man's will becomes restored back. No? So that's why we can now decide whether he will continue with the Lord or he will, whether he will walk with the Lord or he will continue with the evil desires that he used to do. And you will see that man, a born again person, becomes, you know, they become an ocean, turning away from the tendency now is to turn away from the evil ways. They now become to turn to God. Amen? Okay, so his tendency is to do sin. His inclination is his thoughts. The inclination of his thought is evil. Amen? That's why man is called sinner. But when man becomes born again, the free will was restored back to him. Now he can decide whether he will continue with the old ways or will now walk with the Lord. But of course, if you are born again, you will now walk with the Lord. But once in a while, bumabalik pa rin, no? Pero the good news is, we have now the Spirit of God that will convict you not to continue with sin. Amen. That is part of the grace. Share this gospel to the people so that they too may enjoy a walk with the Lord. Amen? Is God?
Spirit.
Is the Lord saving only the spirit? Only the soul? Only the body?
The man.
Or is the Lord saving the spirit, soul, and body?
Oh,
now you know. Hey, clap your hands. Clap your hands to the Lord. Now you understand. The Lord is redeeming not only the spirit, not only the soul, not only the body. The Lord is redeeming the complete being of a person. And that is your spirit, soul, and body. Amen. Mm-hmm. So it's not here. I believe it's here, no? But I will explain it now. Okay. Mas madali kasi yung paliwanag ko na naanas. Simplify ko na lang. Three things you have to remember. Spirit, the first thing that will be saved by the Lord, that will be redeemed by the Lord, starts with the spirit. Man's spirit will be redeemed. Okay? That is what we call justification. Amen? Everybody say justification.
Justification.
When we become born again, when we experience, coming to the Lord by faith, it is redemption. That's when you will experience justification. Your spirit will be justified. Before, your spirit was dead spiritually. But now, when you are justified, your spirit becomes alive. Amen! You now receive the Spirit of God. Now that you are alive, it's a one-time event. Justification is a one-time event. Amen? Following, these are the three stages of salvation. Three stages of salvation, just to simplify. But if you really want to know the order of salvation, it's a little bit longer, but I'm teaching you the very basic about salvation with respect to spirit, soul, and body, for you to understand. Okay? So it's the spirit that is first justified, justification. Then secondly, what is going to be redeemed is your soul. Your soul. Your mind, your emotion, and your willpower. Your will. Okay? I told you, the spirit will be justified once when you are born again. Once. But the soul needs to be sanctified continually. The second stage of salvation is sanctification. Now it is your spirit that is being sanctified by the Spirit of God through the Word of God. Sanctification means walking in righteousness, living in holiness as you keep on learning the Word of God. Your life is being sanctified, being made righteous, being made holy. Amen! Being made good so that we can be able to live a godly life, pleasing in the eyes of God. Amen? Again, that is part of the grace. Again, that's part of God's salvation, part of the grace of God. The grace of God is there from the very beginning up to the end. It never ends. That's why our salvation is purely by the grace. There's no way that a man can save himself and by himself. Even if you choose to put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, it was the unction of the Holy Spirit in your life. Amen? It was the unction, the move of the Holy Spirit in your life in order for you to have that ability to receive Jesus Christ's faith. Remember, you are dead spiritually. Amen? Unless you are regenerated by the Spirit of God, you cannot understand the things that are spiritual. So that is part of the move of God in your life. That is part of the grace. That's why we believe in the five solas of Reformation. Sola Scriptura, no? Sola Gratia, Sola Fide, Solus Christus and Soli Deo Gloria. Ibig sabihin nun, ano pa sila sabi po? Sita na, hindi ako so na. Sinabi ko, Sola Scriptura, we believe in the Scriptura law. Sola Gratia, we believe by salvation, by grace alone. Then Sola Fide, by faith alone. Then Solus Christus by Christ alone. Then Soli Deo Gloria, for God's glory alone. No one will be glorified but God alone. Amen. In our life, from the beginning of our salvation up to the end of our salvation, it is God who started it, it is God who will complete it. Philippians chapter 1 verse 1 verse 6. He has begun a good work in you. He referring to God. God has begun a good work in you. He is faithful to complete it until the day of Jesus Christ, referring to the second coming of Jesus Christ. So sanctification is a continuous process. Part of your sanctification is your Bible training, your Bible study, your attending worship every Sunday or fellowship, receiving the Word of God every now and then. That's why faith comes by hearing the Word of God, the Word of Christ. Amen. Unless you keep on hearing and hearing the Word of God, the Word of Christ, there's no way for you to be transformed from glory to glory until you achieve the likeness of Jesus Christ. No way. And that is part of sanctification. And what is being sanctified in a born-again person's life is the soul. The soul, where the mind, emotion, and the will is sanctified. And that is your personality. That's why a born-again person's personality becomes transformed, becomes renewed. Before, you used to be a bad person, now you become a good person. And that is part of God's grace. Amen? Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. And the third stage, of God's salvation or redemption is glorification. The last stage, no? Third and last stage is glorification. And what will be glorified? Your body. Our body. Our body, which is this flesh. This is a sinful flesh. This flesh is sinful. The nature of this is sinful. That's why there is a battle within. When we are born again, there is a battle within. A battle against this fleshly nature who loves the worldly things, And of course, the new nature, which is this, which is your born again nature, having the Spirit of God in you. So they are now battling together. They are now warring. There's a warring inside. Nakakaroon ng paglalaban. Whether the flesh will abound or not. If now the flesh will only abound if you lack the spiritual passion to continue in the Lord. The flesh will abound only if you lack prayer, if you lack study of the word, if you lack worship, fellowship. Amen? Then you will become spiritually weak. Then the flesh will overcome. Amen?
Amen.
But you are passionate. You have more time. Praising, worshiping, prayer, more time to study the word, more time for fellowship, more time for trainings like this. No? Then you will become strong spiritually and you will be able to overcome. But when Jesus Christ returns, when He comes back, amen, praise the Lord. Why? Because the body will be replaced by a glorified body. And that stage, or last stage, is so-called glorification. It is the body that will be glorified in order for us to have a glorified body, a heavenly body, a body that will no longer be prone to sin, that will no longer be attracted to temptation. Amen? We will receive a perfect body. And by then, the tree, 1 Thessalonians 5:23, the promise of the Lord, it says here, no? Let's read it. 1 Thessalonians 5:23, and may the God of peace Himself sanctify you completely. Who will sanctify you completely? The God of peace Himself. Listen very carefully, people of God. You desire for it, but it is God who will give you the desire and the ability to continue with the ways of God. May the God of peace Himself sanctify you completely. It is God, by His grace, that will sanctify us completely. And may your whole spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why when Jesus Christ returns, when He comes back for the second time around, our body, our spirit, soul, and body will be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And that's where we shall experience our complete redemption for the glory of God. A big hand to the Lord. Come on. Hallelujah. Five solas in the Reformation time, during the time of Calvin and Martin Luther. Amen? Salvation is perfect. Why? Because during that time, Martin Luther was part of the Roman Catholic Church as a priest. But he protested against the Roman Catholic Church because of the wrong teachings. And one of the wrong teachings is salvation is by working for it. You have to work for it. Good works. Salvation is by good works. You have to do good things. No? So that you will be saved. But it's not the way God will save us. It is by His grace. It is God who worked for our salvation. In fact, He has done it on the cross of Calvary. And then He is doing it in our hearts. Amen? God is changing and purifying our hearts so that we may have that will and desire to do the things that glorify. Amen? Can we give a clap of praise to the Lord? So, next meeting, we will discuss the defining the spirit, soul, and body. I will not go over the already discussed the total salvation of amen. Hindi ko na binasa.
Mag-subscribe. Ring the bell. Mag-like. Comment. At i-share mo na.